Hey everyone, welcome back to SFDC Panther. This is Amit and we are in Einstein Next Best Action Part 4. So this is the final part of our NBA and today we are going to discuss about what is generate element and how we can use enhance element in Einstein Next Best Action. So let's quickly start with the implementation of these two elements and we will see how these are more effective while we are working with NBA. We are trying to implement NBA for our customers. So this is a blank strategy builder, a blank strategy that I created using a strategy builder. So first we will see enhance and then we will talk about generate. So how does enhance work? As its name indicates, it makes the enhancement into the existing recommendation that we have, existing recommendation that we do have. So sometimes suppose that we don't know what should be the exact description of our particular recommendation. For example, let's say that we are in opportunity and we wanted to know when that opportunity was last updated, and based on that updated date we wanted to highlight or we wanted to display to our user that this opportunity has been contacted these number of days before ago. Now you need to make sure that you are contacting with the customers and you are saying you are contacting with them in order to close that opportunity. This is the first example. And second example, we can say that if you wanted to offer some kind of discount based on the age of our opportunity, based on the age of our accounts. Let's say that if our account exists into the system for more than 1 year ago, we wanted to offer 10% discounts, and if it exists more than 2 years ago, we wanted to offer 20% discounts. So based on that, we can enhance the requirements and enhance the recommendation, and only those recommendations can be enhanced which we already created into our system. So let's quickly see how we can enhance those. So we have got this load element that we already know how does it work. So we are going to quickly load all the recommendations by putting that id is not equals to null. And now we have got, let's quickly drag and drop enhance element as well, and we will say that enhance recommendation, and for this what it does take, before we go ahead and put this, what is the requirement for this? So either enhance or generate statement, both of these elements required an Apex class, and that Apex class must have a method which is annotated with invocable method. So for this demo I do have two classes, one is for generate and one is for enhance. So for the enhance, what class I do have is, if you see that I have a class here that is enhance underscore get account discount. So this is based on that example where we are checking if the account is existing into our system for more than 1 year ago or 2 years ago or 3 years ago. Based on that, the number that we are getting for that account, we are offering the discount to the customers. So for this, what we have got a method. We will discuss what we are doing inside here. But before that, we are going to discuss high level information just to get that into our recommendation, into our strategy. So the label that we have given is, that is saying enhance with account based on age. This label we will be seeing here. If we click here, here we will see all the classes that have invocable methods, and if you don't see, you can type here. So if you see that we have got enhance with discount based on age, so this is for enhancing the recommendation based on the account age. So let's quickly select this. Once you will select, if you are passing any parameter inside the method of inside your invocable method, it will ask to pass the parameter. Now we have got one parameter that is saying that account ID. So how we are going to pass? As we know that $record is the key to pass the value or to get the value. We have got $record and .id. We are passing the ID of our account because we developed this strategy for account object. Now just click on done, and rearrange the elements. Now we have got three elements. One is for loading all the recommendation, then calling an FS class which is actually doing the enhancement based on the recommendation, what enhancement it is doing we will see just after this, and then we are displaying the outputs whatever the recommendations we are getting. Now let's go back to our developer console, discuss about our class. What does the class takes and how this invocable method look like? So in both cases, generate and enhance, we required a method with invocable method annotation. The requirement for that method is it should be public or global, static, and the return type will always be list of recommendation. And then you have method of your choice, the name of the method name of your choice that you wanted to, and of course for the parameters, what kind of parameter you can pass. It might be of primitive types like string, id, integer, double that you wanted to pass, or you can create your complex type complex data type, which is nothing actually an Apex class, and inside that class you need to have some invocable variables. So to see that, I do have the inner class inside this class, that is data container, and you can also say the class or refer the class as container class. So if we see here, we have got two variables. One is invocable variable, which is saying we need to get the account ID from the recommendation. We need to get the account ID from the strategy builder. And second, we have got invocable variable, which is getting the list of recommendations. But if you have noticed, or we can see this again, it is only asking to get the account ID. It is not asking to get all the recommendation. We have created a variable called recommendations, which is of list of recommendation. How does it work? So while we are working with enhance, we just need to create this list of recommendations inside our data container class, and in this particular variable we are going to get all the recommendations that we are getting from this load statements. We no need to worry about that. We just need to worry about the other parameters or the other variables that we are creating inside our container class. As it is asking for more than one variables, that's why we are creating a container class here. And then again, we are passing list of container, because it will always require list of your data type. Either you are saying list of string, you are saying list of integer, you are saying list of double, you are saying list of long, or any list. Just and make sure that you are passing primitive data types, and you can use Apex class as well, and inside that Apex class it should contain primitive data types, and if you are enhancing, it will be a list of recommendation. Now we have got the variable here, it is a list, so it will always forgetting the first parameter. As we know, list always starts from the zero. That's what forgetting the list of recommendations, what we are saying is that input data, the variable name, and then zero, what is the variable, actual variable that we created inside our container class. Now we are just putting a debug statement here. We have created a list of recommendation just to return at the end of our method. Again, what we are doing here is we are making a query on account object, getting name, description, and created data of our account, and all anyways we are also getting the ID, putting a filter here saying where id in input data 0 and the variable name. And if you have noticed or remember, we are passing the record id here in this variable, so whatever the account we are in or a user in, that account id will be here in this variable. And then we are putting a filter here, and after filtering we have just put a debug statement to check what is the account values. And what we are doing here is we are just getting the difference between created date and today's date. Now we will get the count here, and after that, as our requirement is to get the account is in years, that's why we are dividing by 12, so that we can get the actual numbers that we wanted to get, either it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And then we have got this as of account, just putting a debug statement, checking what is the as of that particular account. And after that, again, we have got a list of recommendations. Why we are saying return recommendations, again, creating, we already created list of recommendations, and we have list of recommendations. Why we are creating this? If you wanted to use this recommendation list, you can use, or if you wanted to create this new one, you can create. I will always recommend to create a new, because this will contain some older values. That's why we don't wanted to make any changes into that list. Now we have got a fresh list. What we are doing is we are iterating with this recommendation list, whatever we are getting from the load statement, putting some checks based on our age count, the variables that we calculated, the actual age of our account. We are saying if the age is less than one, then offer. What are the description we have got? This description is on the description of our recommendation record. As if you see that we are putting a for loop on recommendation object. That's what we are saying, that recommendation, the description, change the description of the actual recommendation, and what will be the new value? It will be description plus offer 1% discount. And we are also changing the acceptance label. What is acceptance label? The acceptance label is in, if we go back to the previous lecture, we saw either it is avail it, or we are not interested, or we don't want it to reject it or view account. That's what this acceptance label is. Now we are saying that offer 1% discount. And then again, we are checking for if the age is greater than 1 and less than or equal to 2, then offer 2% discount. Change the description. The only thing what we are doing is we are just changing the description of our recommendation record. And if none of these criteria match, then that means no discount for this account name. That's what we are getting here. And then what we are doing is return recommendations, that is list of recommendation. We are adding this new recommendation what we changes, and then at the output, what we are doing is we are adding this return recommendations. Now you now let me tell you why we are not using this list, because this list might contain the recommendation which doesn't fall in this criteria. So we don't want it to make changes into those, and we are just making the changes into the recommendation which does fall inside these criteria, within the criteria. And then we are returning this output that is actually list of recommendation. So this is how enhance works. Again, it might be confusing for you. I will make it very simple. Create an invocable method. Make sure it is static, public, or global. Return type will always be list of recommendations. Data type will always be either list of primitive types or list of your container class that you just created. For getting the variables that you are passing from the strategy builder, you will always need to use zero, because in the list you will get the element as a zero position. And then based on that, the logic that you wanted to put, you can put as your own. This is just for an example to show you how enhance works. Now let's get back to our strategy builder here. Now we are trying to save this, test it, and we will see here. And let's type, now we wanted to check this, test this with Burlington Textile Corporation of America. You can see that we are saying now we are getting whatever the description is, validate phone, and we are saying whatever the number of discounts we are getting. We are getting number of discounts, that is only 1% for each and every account. Why we are getting? Because this org is only 10 or 11 months old. That's why we are getting a 1% discount. There no record has been created before 1 year, so that's the reason behind getting 1% discount. Now if you wanted to test in the inspector as well, you can check here in the inspector. You can see that we are getting, okay, let's select this load element, we have got 8. In the enhance element, again we have got 8, and whatever the output we are getting here we have got. This is how enhance work. Now if we even get back to our account record here, by default it is coming as offer 1% discount, because I just tested before while I was preparing the demo. So I'll just refresh this and we'll show you how it is actually looking like. So you can see here now we have got 1% for all these four recommendations. And then again, if you wanted to limit the recommendation, you can use this limit reoffers element and say if a user accepts one recommendation, then that recommendation can appear again after 90 days, 120 days or 10 days, the number of days you can define there. Now let's talk about generate. Before we go ahead, I'd like to mention one thing is that whatever the enhancement we are making using Apex, those enhancements are not going to impact into the original recommendation record that you have created. So the best part is that it is going to show you the data at a runtime, and once you are into different record, you're going to get the data based on that record, and this recommendation will remain as it is, that as it is that you created in a generic way. Now let's talk about generate statement, what it does. As its name indicates, it generates the new recommendation. Suppose that in real time we'll definitely be not be knowing that how many recommendations we need or how many conditions will be there to generate the to create the recommendation. So we can generate recommendation runtime, and these recommendations are also not going to insert or not going to reside into your recommendation. This will be a complete runtime process. You just need to use generate the element, generate the recommendations for you, and just display those recommendations into the record. Again, we just need to drag and drop, and we are going to talk about generate recommendations. Again, we have a class that is accounts to follow up today. So what does this class is doing, we will see. But I will tell you what actually we are going to see in this example. So suppose that we have created a custom field on account saying last contacted date. When we contacted to the account owner, to the particular account, to the third party, third person, whoever is related to that account. And based on that date, we can pop up to our user, or we can tell our user that this account was contacted these much days before. Either visit this account or contact with this contact with the person, or make the necessary changes, whatever the changes that you might have connected with the customer but did not make the changes. So that's what we are doing here. We are checking accounts to follow up today. Again, it is asking for input data. What input data, what is there? We can get back to our developer console. We have got a brand new class for that. Again, that class is having invocable method, a label, a meaningful label that tells the user that what this class, this method is doing. Again, we are talking about what kind of parameter it accepts. It is list of primitive data types. Now for input data, what we are passing here is we are passing owner ID, the ID of a user, whoever the user is logged in. So how, what we are going to pass here is we are going to say that $record.ownerID. That means if I am logging into the system, I will see all the accounts which I need to follow up or when I followed up with those accounts. Now let's click on done here, and again just rearrange the elements. So we need to rearrange here. Cool. What we are doing is we are loading the recommendations, we are making the enhancement on those, and then we are trying to generate some extra recommendations based on the need. What we are doing here is, let's quickly get back to developer console. This will be same, the return type, the method signature, and the what the keyword we are going to use, either static or non-static. And this is the name of your method you wanted to put, you can put. And this is again, we are creating a list so that we can return list of recommendations. we have created a variable saying since days since last contact made with the account. Now we are querying account record saying we wanted to get the name, description, last contact date, and then we have owner ID. Which account we are actually getting? Only those accounts whose owner the logged in user is. That's why we are putting the filter here. Now why we are putting input data 0? Because this is a type of a string. We are not passing any complex data type as an APS class. That's why we are just referencing input data and 0th element. Even you can do this you can do this like this. You can say that owner ID, and then you can use just to get the information from the 0th index, and you can use this as well in your SQL for binding the elements dynamic. Again, we are creating a list so that we can add the recommendations into this list. Now, as we don't have existing recommendation because we are trying to generate, we have got this list of accounts. What are the accounts we are getting under that owner? We are checking if the last contacted date is not null. Even we can put this filter inside our SQL query as well. We can say if this is not equal to null, so that we can get minimum, it should be and. So that we only get those records which meets the criteria that we are providing, the filter criteria inside our SQL in statement. Now what we are saying is, we are checking, let it be, I can make this quick change here. So now we are saying, again we are finding a difference. How many days, number of days. Here we are not dividing by 12 because we just wanted today. And between 2 days, that's what we are saying is the last contact days. And then there is a method inside date class that is date between, and we are saying here with the 2 days date we wanted to get the difference. We are preparing a recommendation here. We are saying is if it is greater than 1, even I just put greater than 1 if you wanted to put greater than 10 or if you wanted to put greater than 15, that means a specific number when you wanted to prompt your user to follow up that account. You can provide those numbers here, or you can use some kind of custom labels, get that label here, so then you can make the changes later on when your requirements gets modified. Now we are preparing a recommendation record. This is same like you are trying to create some standard object. We have got the API name, and then we are providing some required fields that we wanted to. Now again, the only prerequisite for this creating recommendation is the name of your flow, Lightning Flow Builder, that we say. Here I'm using discount flow. This is actually the API name of our flow. You make sure that you have a flow with this API name. If you don't have, go ahead, create a flow, or if you wanted to use your own flow, you just need to go to setup. So I'll just quickly guide you here where you can go is, okay, you can go to setup, and in the quick search bar just find flow. If you have existing flows, you can use those, or if you wanted to use some new flow for that, a particular generated statements or generated recommendations, you can use, or you can create a new flow and then use the API name for that flow. So you just need to follow these steps. You can see that we have got this, and you just need to make sure. You can see we have got employee information. Let's say that you wanted to use account flow. It has a space between two words. So you just need to, or you can say here, okay, I'll just click on this drop down. View details and versions, because I don't want to edit it. And it will open up, and you just need to use this flow API name there inside your, that is accept, what is this? Yeah, this is action reference, the flow, because we know that while creating recommendation, it is always required to get a flow. It might be active or inactive. And then what is acceptance label? You can say view, or you can say that follow up, and rejection label, no thanks. And again, add those output into the, this is the list. we are adding, and then this list should be added into the list that we are returning. Again, the return type list of recommendations. Now if we go back here, save this record, try to test with the same account that we tested. Okay, we can see here account record 1%. Okay, why we are getting only 4 here? Because we have the limit of 4 recommendations here. So now let's quickly try to refresh this page. If you're not able to see, what we will see is we will try to put some limit reoffers elements there and try to accept some recommendations so that we can get the generated recommendations. Okay, we are not getting here. Okay, let's quickly accept this. I'm going to accept 2. Okay, let's quickly finish this. Okay, and we are going to close this, finish this. Now we have got 2. Let's refresh this again. We should be able to get 2 more. Okay, we will be getting those 2 there as well. So what we will do is we will put limit reoffers here. We will say that limit user accepts, and it should come after 90 days. Rearrange the complete flow here. Save it. Now we are okay. We've got now you can see, make a follow-up call to a customer with 1% discount. Okay, discount 15% with 1% discount. Okay, discount 5% with 1% discount. Okay, this is a description, and this is what Astro. Okay, we can check here, or what we can do is we can remove this enhance element because we already did test it. We save it and again test it. We've got make a follow-up call. Okay, discount 15%, Astro discount 5%. Okay, so we are getting the description and the enhancement that we are making. Okay, now our generate statement is not coming here. So what we will see is, let's quickly refresh this page, try to accept few more recommendations so that we can get our generated recommendations. So I just tried to accept 3 recommendations and refresh this page. Okay, now if you see here, we have got, this is a recommendation that we created, and this recommendation is actually generated dynamically. How it is, you can see the acceptance label is follow up that we did put into our APS classes, and even the description, if you see that, connect with this the account name. Okay, and the last instruction was made 31 days ago. Again, we are saying is connect with this account name. Oh, even we see the account name as the top of our recommendation, that is the name of our recommendation. It was contacted 31 days ago, and then it was contacted. If we open this account and try to, let's quickly open this and try to make the change into the last contacted date field. So where it is here, okay, we will try to make this 29th of Feb. Save this. Okay, we're getting some error. Okay, we have got some record fields. Save this record now. Okay, review where we are getting the error. Okay, this active field. Okay, now we have changed this last contacted date to 29th Feb. That means now the number should be different for this particular account. Okay, cool. You can see now we are able to see as 24 days ago. That's 29th Feb, and the today's date is 25th March. That's why we are getting 24 days. So this is how you can work with generate and enhance element, and these are also the key important, or we can say that very important concept while working with NBA. So this is it for the NBA series, and of course you no need to worry about these classes. I'll get these classes into the GitHub repositories, and you will get the link into the description of this videos, and even you will get the link for Salesforce help document as well. And if you have any kind of questions, please feel free to put down into the comment section. I'll definitely get back to you with the explanation, or if you have any kind of suggestions, please feel free to put down into the comment section. And yes, please do like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.